What the fuck's up, everybody? I know it's been a long time since I've been back here. It's been a very, very long time. And I have just one thing to say. God damn, it feels good to be back. And I figured, why not start this off the right way for you guys? You guys ready for this? Because whether you're ready or not, it's about to go down.
Spectrum Móvil es el proveedor de servicio móvil de más rápido crecimiento en el país. Y ahora es el momento de cambiarte. Obtén Spectrum Móvil ilimitado por $29.99 por tu primera línea y cada línea. Haz clic o visita una tienda de Spectrum hoy.
Something weird is going on here. What is going on? Oh. How the fuck is everybody doing tonight? I can honestly say this. Not only out of respect, but out of excitement. And out of gratefulness. That God damn, it feels good to be back. It feels good to be back to my old self. 10 years of battling demons. 10 years of fighting with myself. And battling demons that other people brought upon me. I can honestly say this, it's been a very long time coming. 10 years ago, my fall into darkness began. And over time, I would slowly begin to lose who I was. Because of these fucking terrorists, these people that brought about a hatred to me that I never thought I'd ever seen in my life. I never thought I would see the level of hatred that I saw over these past several years. But I did. I saw it, and it wasn't pretty. It fucking sucked. And bad. But thanks to my motherfucking brother right here, Tibbs, I'm out of that shit now. And Tibbs, I want to say thank you for that, man. You got me out of there and allowed me to rebuild myself. And today, I was actually reunited with a very, very old fan that I never thought I'd see again. This person came back into my life today and showed me quite a lot. This person showed me what it's like to love again, what it's like to be human, and more importantly, what it means to be myself again to the fullest extent. And to that person, I want to say thank you, and I look forward to an amazing future, not only in my life, in your life, but with my job, doing what I love entirely. You showed me how to be myself again, and I thank you for that. Working on it, and it's still going strong. I'm currently 4 songs in to one of them, and about 5 songs in to a few other albums I'm working on. But this next song I'm gonna do, I want to dedicate this one to not only all you guys that showed me love and support over the years, but also I want this to be a big fuck you to everybody that held me down. And what I mean by being held down, I mean those that held me back. I want to dedicate this as a big fuck you to them. You guys ready for this? Let's do this.
Mobile games are going big. Free Fire Max is now available on PC with Google.
Actually, hold up. Let me switch up mics for this. It'll be a lot more fun this way. All we gotta do is this.
Alright. Here we go. Let me crank this up. Alright.
Why is this not that loud? Oh, I know. Hang on, y'all. I made an oopsie. Hang on. I forgot to throw a goddamn gain on this. My bad. Ah, fadoodle.
All I wanted was a smile, all I wanted was...
Hold up, y'all. Let me check something real quick here. Thousand bitches and lots of bitches. For real, man.
Oh, That grimy film on your teeth.
Dr. J. This year, she'll be able to find the bright side.
Now, I do have a question for everyone in here. And I only ask this because I give a fuck about you guys. I truly care about all y'all, man. How many of you guys, like myself, have dealt with depression or know someone that has? Because I can tell you right now, I have. How many of you guys in the comments right now have dealt with depression or some form of addiction or know somebody that has dealt with that? But here's the thing, that's not up to me, that's up to them. How many of you guys want to hear some unreleased shit? How many of y'all in the comments want to hear some of my unreleased shit that I got going on? What about you, Tibbs? Actually, matter of fact, Tibbs, the one I'm about to do, I think you might know this one, dude, because if I'm not mistaken, I think I sent you this one a while back. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think you might know this one. Ah, here we go. This song is called "Let the World Hear My Rage." Yo, Morbid, what up, man? Welcome, welcome, welcome. How you doing, man? Welcome to my little part of YouTube, brother. How you doing, man? Oh, it's just dead skin. But yo, how you doing, man? For real, dude. Hell, even I'm a fan of his work, Tibbs. And yo, Morbid, not gonna lie, man. I love your videos, man. What you do is fucking dope. Keep that shit up, man. Fucking love watching your videos, dude. You bet you got some good shit. I'm not gonna spoil it, dude. Go to his channel and check it out. I promise you'll love it, dude. Trust me. Just go to his channel, check his shit out. I don't want to ruin the surprise for you, man. Hey, that was a good one. Not gonna lie, that was a good one, bro. But yo, what brings you over here, dude? How you been, dude? What brings you over to this little part of YouTube of mine, man? What brings you over here to my little corner of the internet, bro? What's going on, dude? Taking a day off from going after assholes? Jesus. Oh shit, that's what's up, dude. I appreciate that, dog. And yo, Morbid. First off, I want to say what you do is fucking badass. What you do is fucking awesome, dude. We need more than motherfuckers like you out there, man. We do. We need more people like you and Tibbs and me and the motherfuckers that hate these fucking pedos. We need more guys like you out there raising awareness about this shit. Matter of fact, this next one is going out to you, Morbid. That's a fair way to put it, dude. That's actually a very fair way to do it. Now this next one is going out to my fan that I got back in contact with today. Because like me, they are a massive fan of this band. Just like I am. And just like I'm sure a lot of you guys are too. So, to that fan that's probably watching right now, what up? Love you to death, you're fucking awesome. And this next one is for you. I'm sure you guys will know this one.
Oh my God, here we go.
Yo, Tibbs, I want you to pick a song, your favorite song from the band. Linkin Park. What's your number one favorite song from them? That song was Freak on a Leash by the legendary band Korn. Ooh. That's a good one, dude. And that's actually one of my top favorites as well. Now, right when the music kicks in and I say go, I want you guys to put Hashtag RIP Chester and hashtag fuck suicide in the comments. But not until I say. You guys ready for this? Chad, you better chill right now, man. Because here, what he thinks is real and isn't real, that's his choice. When you come here to set your burdens down. Because life is hard. Life is very hard. And when you come to this channel, you come here to set down your burdens. We are all equal here. Do you understand that? We are all equal. No one here judges anyone. Unless you're a pedophile, then that's different. Then you get yeeted the fuck up out of here. And Chad, let this be a lesson to you. I'm not gonna ban you. Not yet. But if you continue to judge, you yourself will be thrown out. Is that very clear? Because when you come here, you are among friends. You are among people that care. You are among people that want to make a difference in this world and on this platform. Because trust me, just like you, Chad, I used to be a lot like you. I actually did. Back in the day, I used to be just like you were, man. I used to judge people on everything. I'm not gonna lie, back then, I was a piece of shit asshole. Always judging everybody. Always judging them on literally everything. On what they believed, what they thought was real and wasn't real. Hell, I even judged them by how they look and the taste of their music. I was that motherfucker. But then I learned real quick that we all have one thing in common. At the end of the day, we all bleed red. We are all the same on the inside. Just because we believe different things doesn't make us any different from each other. We are all human. We all bleed red. And we all deserve caring and understanding. So judgment will not be put up with here. Unless you are a pedophile, then yes, if you are a pedo, you will be judged and you will be taken care of. But when you come here, there is no judgment. There is no hatred. Do you understand that? What up, Tibbs? I'm a meat popsicle. Yo, Tibbs, what's your request, bro? What do you got, man? Here's the thing, dude. To Peter Griffin, let me answer a question for you. Okay. I'll do that in just a sec. But first, let me answer this question by Peter Griffin. Yeah. Sorry, Peter. Had to do it. But here, unless you've done some pedophile shit, you will not be judged. Unless you've done something that deserves to be called out, we don't care about your history. We all make mistakes, we all fuck up. But it's how we learn from those mistakes going forward and what we do about it that makes us who we are. So unless you're a pedophile, then you will not be judged. Because we all fuck up, we all make mistakes. I'm not perfect. No one on the face of this earth is perfect. We all fuck up. We all make mistakes. We all do shit that we're not supposed to. So unless you're a pedophile, you will not be judged, my friend. I promise you that. Because here, like I stated earlier, when you come here, you are in a safe place where you can hang out, have a good time, and be yourself. Because trust me when I say, I know what it's like to go through life on a very hard level. Because let's be honest, life is hard. We all deal with a lot of shit that we shouldn't have to. And when you come here, this is a way for you guys to be released, to hang out, have a good time, and set your burdens down, no matter what it is. You can come here and set your burdens down, knowing that you have a place to call your home. Because I want to build a community of like-minded people, full of caring, understanding, love, and respect for each other. I want this community to be one of the best fucking communities on this fucking platform. I want people to be able to come here and tell their story about what they've went through. I want you guys to be able to share your stories about everything that you've gone through. Because like me, I've gone through a lot of fucked up shit. And I do mean a lot of fucked up shit. I've had assassination attempts. I've been shot at. I was unlawfully arrested. I was assaulted. Beat down. Held back from a lot. And I can honestly say, getting away from all that, it wasn't easy. Ooh, unfortunately, Tibbs, I don't know that one. I wish I did, man, but unfortunately, I don't, dude. But I do have something to remedy that. Please be one that I know. Please make it one that I fucking know. Please, thank you. I would very much appreciate that. But I am going to check that one out for sure. Because just looking at the cover art, it looks fucking cool as shit. Ooh, I like that one. Sorry, y'all. Just texting my fan, waiting for them to comment. And that way I can mod them up so they don't get banned. And yeah. Ooh, I haven't heard that one in a while. I'll have to re-listen to that one. But I do know that one. I'll just have to re-listen to it because it's been a while. But I do know one for you, man. Matter of fact, this song right here is actually going to, eventually, hopefully one day, I want this song to be the anthem for this channel.
You know that feeling of having to rewash dishes that didn't get clean? I don't.
Platinum Plus is Cascade's best clean ever. With double the Dawn and double the scrubbers, it removes the toughest grease and residue for an irresistible clean and shine. Cascade Platinum Plus. Dare to dish differently.
We on that next level.
And track calls Monster, a unique blend of quality.
Where is all of my fellow Black Veil Brides Army at? Where's my fellow Black Veil Brides Army at, man? Where you guys at right now? Let me just set to do something real quick. No, right here.
Found them.
But where's my fellow Black Veil Brides Army at, man? Because this next one is going out to you guys. Now, y'all wanted some old school shit? I got you for some old school shit, bro. Give me just a second.
Watch world-class soccer live on a variety of networks all season long.
When you live with moderate to severe Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, your day can be full of reminders of your condition. You were...
This next song right here. I want to dedicate this next one to my motherfucking brother overseas in Australia right now. I want to dedicate this to my motherfucking brother, Clint, who right now is in a fight of his life. Because right now, this man is fighting a very, very hard battle of addiction. So Clint, if you're watching this, brother, I want you to know that me, Mom, Ed, we all fucking love you, bro. And we all have your fucking back. So keep up that fucking fight, dude. You're doing fucking great. Keep that shit up and never fucking give in. And I hope that this song right here keeps you fucking going, bro. We fucking love you, man. You got this.
It's Etsy's Valentine's Day sales event. Get up to 40% off gifts made by real people until February 14th.
Nope.
Save on jewelry, jackets, homeware, and more. For up to 40% off handmade gifts, Etsy has it. Shop Etsy.com.
I can say this with honesty. There will never be a truce between me and that pedophile-loving music bitch face Marty. There will never be a truce between us, ever. He's the main one that put me in the position that I was in for all those years. So as far as I'm concerned, there is no truce with that fat ass. He's nothing but scum. He may not be a pedophile, but he's a pedo supporter. But enough about that fuckface. I have a question for everyone here. How many of you guys have people, friends, family, friends that you consider family? How many of y'all know somebody that's currently serving overseas in our military or know somebody that did and didn't make it back? Because I know I do. I have a lot of friends that served in our military, but unfortunately they never made it back home. Some did, some didn't. How many of you guys know somebody that served and either made it back home or didn't make it back home or is currently serving right now? Because this next song, I want to dedicate to all of our men and women in uniform who actually did serve and paid the ultimate price for our fucking freedom. Because a lot of people think that our military don't put their lives on the line every day. But trust me when I say they do. And I do want to say this one thing before I get this going. That yes, my now former dad, I may not like him. I may not be able to stand him, but I still respect the fact that he served our military. Yes, he may be a piece of shit, but he still served nonetheless. And that's the only thing I respect about him. But above all else, I support all you guys that have friends and family that have served alongside those that paid the ultimate price. This song is for them. Some of you guys might even recognize this.
Check out these deals of the week.
That's true. That's facts. And I was there when you met her, too. I was there. I witnessed it firsthand for myself. You know what's funny about all this, man? What makes me laugh about all this? The fact that a lot of these trolls seem to think that they can run our lives. These people think they can tear us down, destroy us, walk all over us. And I say this right now, that simply is not true. Because let me tell you guys right now, I went through hell and back over these last 10 years. And I can say this without shame. That 3 years ago, because of these people that do all this, I almost joined everybody like Chester. Twice in a row, I attempted to take my own life because of these people. But on the second time, after not succeeding, that's when I realized that I was put here for a fucking reason. And that reason showed up in the form of exposing this evil plague that is on this platform and all over the internet. my mission in life is to help people like myself. Because I was once there. I was once on the edge. And let me tell you, I hated every minute of it. I didn't know that there was people that I could turn to. I felt like I didn't have anybody. I felt like the world would be better off without me. I felt like, what's the point in living if this shit won't stop? What was the point in living? I didn't understand it. Why I was still here. Why I didn't succeed. But now I understand. My job, my goal, and my reason is to build this community. My job and my goal for this channel is to build this community up of awesome people like you guys in the comments. My goal is to ultimately flesh out and be rid of every single troll that does the shit that these people did to me, that these people did to Tibbs, and that some of these people did to you guys. And if you guys are in that position right now, I want you guys to know that you are not alone. You have people right here in the chat that care about you. You got people like me and Tibbs who actually give a shit. And I'm not just saying that either. I genuinely fucking mean that shit. Because I've been there, and no one deserves to fucking be there. So I tell you right now, you guys that feel trapped, that feel like you don't have anyone to turn to, yes, you do. You have this community right here. All of us here care about you guys. Everyone here in the comments is here for you guys. And if you guys have a burden that you're carrying, please, when you come here, please hand us your burden. We will take care of that shit. We will help you the best we can. Because when you come here, this is your chance to set down that burden. I know I have channels that I go watch when I need to set down my burdens as well. Just like you guys. I have channels that I go watch where I go to hang out and set my burdens down when I feel like the world is hard. And I want to be that person for you guys. I want those of you that didn't get to know me before all this shit happened. I want you guys to be able to see who I was before that shit happened. I want you guys to see the real me. The me that I was before all this. And I want to use that version of me to help as many people as I fucking can. Because let me tell you, this trolling shit, it's a plague. It's a virus that needs dealt with. And for those of you wondering that know my history entirely in great, great, great detail, there's a part of my life that I will be focusing on later this year. And that part of my life isn't music. It isn't gaming. It isn't going out and doing live shows. No. This part of me is something that I've been a part of since I was a kid. And that part of me is called Operation Smile. And if y'all don't know what Operation Smile is, allow me to tell you. Operation Smile travels around the world to give free surgeries to kids, adults, and people all over the world who were born with facial deformities such as cleft lip, cleft palate, all that shit. And let me tell you, I've been proud. I'm proud to be able to say that I've been able to go on missions here throughout Ohio to help those people out. And I am proud to say that I am part of that to this day still. And that part of me, I will never let the trolls take away from me. Yo, Crizzy, what up? Hey, Adriana, what up? But yeah. Yeah. I'ma take it over there and bring it right back. But the reason why I bring up Operation Smile is for a very important reason. Because one, not only have I been a part of them for years and have the card to prove it. And for those of y'all that I know are gonna talk shit, let me prove it to you. I received this on the very first local mission that I ever did around here with OS. And I'm proud to say that I was part of this. And I will forever be part of this. This part of me right here that did this will never fucking die. Matter of fact, this next song was actually the anthem for Operation Smile for a lot of years. This song is called Through the Eyes of a Child by Saul Erna. And some of you might know his voice. So to Saul, again, that song as an anthem was fucking amazing. And to the people that run Operation Smile directly, I want to say thank you guys for giving me the opportunity all those times to be able to go with you guys to help people. You guys gave me an experience that I will never forget and that I will always hold close to me.
Watch football all season long, live and
Sorry, y'all. Ring your shit, dude. Tibbs, you know I'm ring your shit, motherfucker. You know, I do want to speak on something that somebody here in the comments said, and that is this. A lot of people say that I'm famous, that I have a name to me, this, that, and the other, and that may be true. I may be famous. That may be true. But I personally do not see myself as famous. I see myself as a regular dude doing what he loves, and that's it. I'm a regular ass dude just doing what he loves. I never have and never will see myself better than anybody. I'm no better than you guys. Y'all are no better than me. I see myself as y'all's equal. I love being on the same level as everybody, man. I enjoy that. I enjoy the hard work. Because unlike certain people, like PFV, I don't let the money go to my head. Never have and never will let it go to my head. He was a sellout. Turned his back on his own friends. But me, I'm never turning on my motherfucking people. Ever. That is the one thing I will never fucking do, is turn my back on any of you guys. Because a lot of you guys have been down since day fucking one. And I appreciate the ever-living fuck out of all you guys. And to me, you guys, you're not fans. To me, you guys are extended family. To me, you guys are friends of mine. I don't see you guys as fans. I see you guys as my equal, as my friends, as extended family. That's what I see you guys as, and I always fucking will. Oh, and just for the record, to anybody out there that thinks that I'm gonna sign to a label, here's my answer. Fuck a label. I don't need a label. Because I have the best fucking fan base in the fucking world. I don't need a fucking label to make something of myself. But this song right here, this is my motherfucking promise to all you guys, to my motherfucking brother CIA ho, all the way down to my motherfucking little brother Tibbs. Well, older brother Tibbs. My brother nonetheless. This song right here is my motherfucking never-ending promise to you guys. By the way, where's my fellow? By the way, this next one is going out to that fucking sellout, PFV. Oh, trust me, as soon as we hit 1,000 subs, Your boy's putting out some fucking merch with my artwork on it, man. For fucking sure.
Mobile games are going big.
This song right here.
Sometimes the end of a long run
Let's see, where's it at? Sorry, I was trying to find something real quick.
These men disappeared 48 hours ago.
We are this
150.
Now this next song, y'all. Tibbs knows this person in a sense, because he was a fan of this person, just like I was. And this person that I'm speaking about. Is unfortunately no longer with us. And that person person's name will ring forever through time as an example of what these trolls push people to do. And that person is the Inquisitor. Now, if y'all don't know who the Inquisitor is, y'all need to look him up. Because trust me when I say, his story is very, very heartbreaking. But I wanted to dedicate this song to him, as I promise to not only him, but to you guys, that no matter what, I will continue to fight the good fight for you guys and to keep on keeping his legacy alive. Yo, Neptune. Oh my god, yo, Neptunes, I got you, bruh. Yo, Neptunes, what the fuck is up, dude? This man right here, Neptunes, is a motherfucking OG up in here, man. This dude is a fucking day oneer. What the fuck is up, dude? Long time no motherfucking see, bruh. How the fuck you been, man? What's good? This dude right here is a day oneer for fucking sure. But as I was saying, this song is not only for you guys, but this song is also for the Inquisitor to keep his legacy and what he stood for alive in all aspects. Like I said, this promise is not only for you guys, but for him as well.
Mobile games are going big with mobile play games.
Experience
more ways to play Free Fire Max to the fullest with your PC and sync your progress across mobile and desktop devices. Download and play today with Google Play Games.
Oh, yo, by the way, at Neptune. Here's a little throwback for you, dog.
Question. What is the best no Wi-Fi game for a long ride? As you asked.
Y'all know what that sound means.
Hey, yo, Tiz, this did seem weird to you. This Michael did, does it seem weird? Just wondering. Let me answer something real quick. All right, cool. Just making sure. Yo, Tibbs, since you're a gamer, dude, since you're like me and you're a gamer, bro, I think you might enjoy this. Now, Neptune, I know you've heard me do this before, man. Matter of fact, I know you've heard me do this one before, Neptune. You ready for this, bro? Let's get it.
The buck.
I want the fucking ending. The ending's fucking awesome.
Bitch!
Oh shit, that was loud.
LegalZoom makes it simple to start.
I'm just kidding. I got one more for you guys, man. And you know I gotta do this final one to throw it in the trolls' faces. Y'all know I gotta do it, bruh. I think you might know. No, I did that as a final song for a very fucking important reason. To let y'all trolls know that you ain't stopping me this time. And you ain't ever going to stop me this time. I can promise you that. Well, that being said, man, I hope you guys enjoyed this, man. I definitely had fun, and I hope you guys did, too. Tomorrow, I will be doing a couple streams on here, actually. I will be doing a gaming stream with my boy Tibbs, and I'll also be doing a gaming stream on PC, because your boy's going to be jumping back into some Flash Party starting tomorrow. On here, we're going to be doing some ranked matches and having a good time, man. But with that being said, man, I fucking love you guys, and I'll catch you all tomorrow, man. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and yo, Neptune, welcome back, brother. Good to see you back, dog. Glad to have you back, man. Fucking love you, bro. And everybody else, fucking love y'all, man. As always, as I always say, stay humble. Stay positive, keep being yourself, keep doing what you love, and fuck the haters, man. You guys are awesome. I fucking love y'all, dude. And, yeah, starting tomorrow, y'all can look forward to some fun shit, man. Love you guys, man. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace. Oh, and, fuck the trolls, and fuck the pedos. Love you guys, man. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.